Welcome to Sesame Street, I guess. Welcome to a really boring day. Nothing's happening. Same old bunches around here. Even the weather's nice. Not a cloud in the sky. But there's something else, and it's coming straight down. Why, it's a bird? It's a plane? It's a trash can?
That was a great landing.
That face!
That face!
That fur!
That fur!
That trash can!
The trash can!
Get lost?
Get lost yourself?
You're a grouch!
So are you!
Well, I said it first. Where you from?
Hey, I'm from outer space. I'm Othmar the Grouch from the planet Zircon.
Yeah, well, I'm Oscar the Grouch from Sesame Street, planet Earth, which is where you are, I'm sorry to say. Wow.
What was that noise? Oh, it shook the whole place.
The whole place shook. Well, of course! Haven't you ever seen a spaceship land before? This is Othmar from the planet Zircon.
That face.
And that fur. And the trash can.
Wait a minute. It's the Grouch from outer space.
Oh, Linda, how do you welcome a Grouch from outer space? Say, get lost.
Ready?
Ready?
Get lost!
Hey, I think I'm gonna like it here.
L. L. Large. L. L. Little. Large. Little. L.
This is the legend of Lord Lester. Now, maybe you can guess that in this story, there are lots of words that begin with the letter L. This is a letter L, this is a letter L, and this is a letter L. Lots of times, you'll be hearing the L sound, and that goes like this. Ooh, ooh. So look and listen and see if you can hear that L sound, okay? Here we go. Once long ago, Lord Lester lived in a lofty castle with his lovely wife, Lady Lulu.
Lady Lulu!
Well, Lord Lester!
As well as their loyal lackey, Louie, and their pet lizard, Lancelot.
Well, lizard!
Then one day, after a late lunch of liver, lettuce, and lemonade, Lord Lester laughed and said,
Ever since I was a little lad, I have liked the letter L. In fact, I love it so much, I am going to latch on to everything that starts with L.
Land sakes, that's a lovely idea, Lester!
So he rang for Louie, the loyal lackey, and announced loudly,
Louis, our loyal lackey, look for everything you can locate that starts with the letter L and leave them in our living room.
So Louis made up a long list and began lugging L things into Lord Lester and Lady Lulu's living room until, at length, it was loaded.
Lady Lulu, look what our loyal lackey has left us. Why, here's a lamp. And a lobster.
Lovely.
A lot of leaves and lemons.
Luscious.
A long ladder.
Lofty.
A log, a lantern, a lock, and a life preserver.
Oh, and lastly, a lollipop for Lulu.
Lady Lulu, here's your lovely little lamb.
Louie!
Let lazy lackeys lie, Lulu.
And Lord Lester and Lady Lulu lived happily ever after with all the elf things Louie, the loyal lackey, had labored to bring them. Moral, it's okay to lose your lid over the letter L as long as you have a loyal lackey like Louie to lift everything.
Loyal schmoyal? I'm gonna go live in a lighthouse.
That lousy loafer!
He left us!
So don't push your luck.
You know what fear is?
Sure. It means being afraid of something.
Are you afraid of anything?
Only one thing.
Me?
Nope.
The dark?
Nope.
Loud noises?
Nope.
Ghosts?
Nope.
Then what the heck are you afraid of?
Fear!
This is a wheel that we found. We're going to make the wheelbarrow out of it. You want to spin it? See how it spins? Works pretty good, doesn't it? More pieces on it before stay together. Okay, Sabre, can you hand me the drawing? I've got to look at the drawing. Yeah, thanks.
I'm going to try this.
You know why we're sanding this, Sabre? It's so that we get all the splinters off the edge. Yeah.
Try it out.
job saving. That's really big help.
The Little Letter L, a poem by Louise. I love the little L. It doesn't curve and swing in circles like some letters I could mention. It just stands there at attention. I love the letter L. Little L, you don't lean or lay below the line like Y does. Little L, you never get crossed like T's or dotted like I does. L, you're the little letter I wish I was. Little L.
Ooh. Hey, Othmar, you think this thing's gonna be able to get off the ground?
Oh, sure, of course it flies. I came all the way from the planet Zircon, didn't I?
Oh, yeah.
Say, Oscar, what's going on?
Well, Othmar's gonna take me for a little ride.
Oh, yeah? Where are you going?
To the moon.
Oh. The moon?
What are you, an echo? Yeah, to the moon.
Well, how do you plan to get there? In this trash can?
Well, can you think of a better way? Look, as a matter of fact, Olivia, you could help us take off. We need a countdown, see?
Oh, okay.
So you count from 10 down to 1, and then after 1, we'll take off.
You're going to take off?
Yeah.
Yeah, okay.
Okay. Mm-hmm. Hey, Othmar, Olivia's going to count us down, so we're all set.
All right, okay. Prepare to take off. Yeah. Start her up, Othmar.
Shit.
Okay, Olivia, start your countdown.
All right. 10, 9, 8.
Hold it. Olivia?
Mm-hmm.
Could you hand me that brown paper bag there that's on the mailbox?
Oh, all right.
We almost forgot our lunch.
Oh. You sure you're going now?
Yeah, okay.
All right.
Ready? Okay. Countdown.
Okay. 10, 9. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1.
You're sick, huh?
Whoa! Want me to turn any of these switches on for you?
Yeah, turn the thermostat.
What's happening?
Yeah, we're just falling apart, Oscar. Don't worry.
Oh, I love it.
Well, now I've seen everything.
Hey, look at that. We're leaving the Earth. Now there's nobody up here but you and me, alone at last.
Yeah, if you want to be alone, outer space is the place to be, Oscar.
So that's the Earth. What's all that white stuff?
Them's the clouds, Oscar.
Too bad it looks so pretty.
Hey, what's going on?
We're going through the space dump.
Space dump?
Yeah, there are lots of old satellites and rockets up here that the Earth people leave up here, you know.
Wow! There is trash in outer space!
There it is, Oscar. Your moon.
Hey, it looks just like an old tennis ball I found in the trash last week.
Okay, Oscar, we're coming in for a landing. Keep your eye out for someplace bumpy.
Oh, yeah. You're a grouch after my own heart.
Hey, look at that. So that's what the moon looks like up close. Not bad. It's got little holes all over it. What a beautiful mess.
Yeah, this is nothing. Wait till you see it closer.
I can't wait. Hey, Othmar, I'm getting a little hungry. How about you?
Yeah, I guess so. Traveling makes me hungry, too. What do you got?
Well, let's see, pastrami and peanut butter on stale rye. Jerky and clams on an old club roll.
Yeah, I'll take that.
How's yours?
Just terrible.
Yeah, mine too.
Look, Oscar, we're really close to your moon now.
Wow, what a place! No trees, no houses, and best of all, no people! Just a big desert with a lot of holes in it. What a spot for a vacation!
Yeah, I know.
Hey, let's land this thing, Othmar, and then we can look around for a minute. Then we better get back to Sesame Street.
Hey, what's the rush?
Well, I just remembered. I haven't insulted Olivia all day. She's gonna think I don't care.
Okay, we're down.
Circle. Square. Triangle. Rectangle. Trapezoid. Pentagon. Hexagon. Octagon.
There's a fly in my soup. Could you do something about it?
There is a fly in your soup in this establishment?
Yeah.
I shall do something about it instantaneously, sir. Yes, sir. A fly in your soup. I shall take care of that, yes. Let's see. A fly in your soup. Are you sure it was a fly, not a noodle or maybe a piece of hair? Let me see. I am looking in the soup, sir, and I do not see a fly in the soup.
No, waiter. I believe I said in the soup, and you're looking under the soup.
I knew that. Anybody knows that. I knew I was looking under the soup and not in the soup. All right, I will now look in the soup.
Thank you. You're welcome.
All right, in the soup. Let me see. Here, little fly. No. I am looking in the soup, sir, and I do not see a fly.
Waiter, you're looking next to my soup. The fly isn't next to my soup. The fly is in my soup.
Well, of course. Of course it is in
yes,
your soup.
Of course.
Do not accuse me of not knowing what next to an in means.
Of course.
All right. Just... I will look in the soup now.
Thank you.
For this supposed fly. All right, in the soup. Oh, fly, little fly, cute little fly. No, I am looking in the soup and I do not see a fly, sir. I think you are mistaken.
No, now you're looking on my soup. You see, the fly isn't on my soup. It's not under my soup.
What?
It's not next to my soup. The fly is in my soup,
what?
And you haven't even looked in my soup. You looked everywhere but in my soup.
But, sir, then where do you want the fly?
I don't want the fly anywhere.
Then why did you ask for a bowl of fly soup?
I didn't ask for a bowl of fly soup.
You should have asked for a bowl of soup and said, hold the flies.
That's will you bring me another bowl of soup?
The customer is always right.
Thank you.
You're welcome, sir. I shall bring you another bowl of soup.
Good.
I don't believe this. Charlie, draw one.
12,000 restaurants. I don't know why I have to come to this one.
Charlie, I think we got a weirdo here. He comes here a lot.
Calm down.
All right, sir. I think I shall be making you very happy with this.
Yes.
Here we are, our special soup of the day.
And what kind of soup is that?
Cream of mosquito. Where's my tip?
Does a horse have
one?
No. How many?
Two.
Nope. How many?
Three.
No. How many?
Four.
Yes.
One, two, three, four. Yay!
Michelle?
Wow.
Do you speak Spanish?
Yes.
Oh, that's wonderful. Could you help me?
Yes.
Because, see, I know what some things are called in English, but I don't know what they're called in Spanish. So I'll ask you, I'll tell you what they are in English. You tell me what it is in Spanish, and we'll point to it together, okay? All right, now, this is nose in English, right?
Yeah.
What is that in Spanish?
A nariz.
Nariz. Okay, you point to your nariz. Nariz. Nose. Nariz. Good. Oh, now, what about this?
Eyes.
Eyes, right. That's in English. What is it in Spanish?
Ojos.
Ojos. Ojos. Ojos. Eyes. Okay, what about mouth?
Boca.
Boca. Boca. Mouth. Ojos. Eyes. And...
Nose.
Nose.
A nariz.
A nariz. What about,
Hair? Hair! Hair.
Hair? What's hair?
Hair, pelo.
Pelo. Pelo is hair. Pelo. What about?
Eyebrows.
Eyebrow.
I don't know.
Me either.
La Viva so Viva Viva is a non effaver, nothing can move me!
Till he gets back. But what do we do while we wait? You have an idea? That's the sign for the moon. Can you guys do that? Yeah, sort of like a C. Comes out from your eye. There. That's it. For moon. Now how do people get to the moon? How do people get to the moon? What do they ride in?
Rockets.
Oh, it cross your finger like for good luck. The rocket goes up. Oh, that's great. We're going up to the moon in the rocket. Okay, now, see, I wonder what Oscar is seeing besides the moon. What else does he see up in space? What else is there?
Garbage.
Of course, Oscar would see garbage. But what are the things that twinkle in the sky?
Stars.
What's the sign for stars? Oh, this is the sign for stars. Oh, great. Great. Now, you know what? We could have a signing game. A signing game. Yeah. And everybody can be, we can have a star. Who wants to be a star? Okay, you be a star. And you want to be a star?
I want to be a rocket.
You want to be a rocket. Do you want to be a star? Come on, you two be stars. Up the stairs. And you come and be the moon. All right? Okay, stars stop right there. Okay, and the moon goes up a little further. Okay? Okay, you stop right there. Right there. Turn around. Okay, now you go up. Now, you're going to be the rocket. Okay, we're going to have a blast off. Okay, and you're going to go up to the stars. That's the moon and up into outer space. Ready? Can we all give a countdown? Okay, everybody make their sign. Stars and you're the moon, so you do this. All right? And you're this. You're the rocket. Ready? All right, we're going to count down. Ready? From 10 to 1. 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. The rocket is on the moon. But that reminds me, Oscar still isn't back. He's late.
X. Exit. Okay, everybody out.
Everyone out of the exit door, the exit door, the exit door. Everyone out of the exit door.
And please, don't let it slam! X. Exit.
And now, country western fans, the grand old Sesame Street Opera proudly presents Sesame Street's country sweetheart, Miss Polly Darton.
Thank you, dear folks. I'm right proud to be here at the Grand Ole Sesame Street Opera to introduce a brand new song. It's called I'm Waving Goodbye to You with My Heart. Let's go, boys. Oh, I'm so sorry to see that. stem to stern. And so every single part of me wants to say goodbye in turn. Oh, I'm so sorry to hear that you'll be traveling. I hope that you know I'll always care.
Sleep.
And then in the springtime,
wake up. Now it's summer.
What do they have in them?
Milk.
And then what do you like to do with milkweed pods?
Open them up at fall for seaweeds or seeds in it.
And then where do you think they go?
They blow.
And then what happens to them?
They grow a new one.
And that happens over and over again every spring.
Everything is lined up properly
Mumpy,
now.
Mumpy! Oh, Mumpy, there you are! How are you, Mumpy?
Oh, no.
Hey, Mumpy.
Yes?
Are you going to do another trick? I just love your tricks.
Well, there's no show today, Sonny. I'm just practicing.
Oh, Mumpy?
Yes?
Can I watch you practice?
Well, all right, but you must be very quiet.
Oh, yes, be very quiet. Where do I stand?
All right. Right there is okay. Up a little forward there is fine. Okay. Now.
Yes.
Where was I?
Oh, I don't know.
Oh, yes.
Anywhere.
Yes.
I like it all.
I am now going to make a rabbit come out of this hat. I wave my magic wand and say the magic words, a la peanut butter sandwich.
How did it go, Monty?
Something is wrong. No rabbit.
Yeah, lots of smoke, but no rabbit, huh?
Well, here we go. One more time.
Okay.
Now, ladies and gentlemen, I'm going to wave my magic wand and say the magic words, and a rabbit will appear in this hat.
Oh, boy.
A la peanut butter sandwich.
Oh, boy, the rabbit still did not come. I wonder where that rabbit is, Mumpy.
Well, I don't know, but this is the last time I'm going to try. I will wave my magic wand.
Okay.
Say the magic words.
Yeah.
And the rabbit will appear in the hat.
Good.
A la peanut butter sandwich.
Oh.
Well, it didn't work. I don't know. I guess I'll have to work on that trick again tomorrow. Well, I don't understand anyway. But...
Poor Mumpy. He did not make rabbit come up. Oh, well. Bye-bye.
In the early days of the West, the peaceful town of Snidler's Gulch was threatened by one of the meanest desperados of all time, Cowboy X, a man who left his mark everywhere. Hitch, Cowboy X!
Letter X! Whoa! Letter X! Yippee!
Cowboy X left X's everywhere, on the houses, on the streets, in the schoolhouse, X's on the horses, X's on the town hall, even on the good citizens of Snidler's Gulch themselves.
X! X! Yippee!
The citizens finally decided that Cowboy X had to be stopped.
Throw him in jail. Run him out of town.
Wait, what if we just ask Cowboy X to please stop marking up our town with X's?
The kid's got an idea.
It's so crazy, it might work.
Here comes Cowboy X now.
X! Woohoo! X! Yippee! X!
Cowboy X, would you please stop marking X's all over our town?
Why, sure I'll stop. Oh. Oh. From now on, I'll be known as Cowboy O. Yippee!
And the citizens of Snidler's Gulch lived happily ever after because they really weren't very smart.
Why is everybody looking up?
We're waiting for Oscar to come back down.
To come down?
Oh, yeah. See, Oscar went up to space with Othmar, his space friend.
Oh, yeah.
In the trash can. So now we're just waiting for him to come back down.
Yeah, if he ever does.
Oh, well, what's this big circle over here in the ground?
Oh, Oscar and Othmar told me to put the circle over there so they'd know where to land, see? Yeah, I had to mark that spot so they know to land on it. Yeah.
Oh.
It's hard to see things from up there in space. Yeah, and if they didn't have that circle, why they'd land on China or something.
China?
China.
Yeah. If he ever does come down.
You're gonna miss the circle!
No, we're not.
Yes, we are! You know, you're really a rotten driver, you know that?
What? Me? I thought you were driving.
Well, I ought to be. Give me the steering wheel.
Here you go.
What are you doing? Are you crazy? Look out!
Boy, my steering wheel is all busted up, my exhaust system is clogged, and look at my antenna, it's drooping. I'll never get home to Zircon now.
Yeah, and that's not the worst part of it.
Yeah, what is?
You missed the circle.
Oh.
Hicks.
The largest paperclip collection in the Western Hemisphere is in Muskegon, Michigan. Wow! I think I'll move to Muskegon. Paperclips come in varying sizes.
Old Buddy Bird is really involved in his book. I think he's so involved in his book he doesn't even know I'm here. Hey, that gives me an idea. This is a great time for me to show you all about fear, what it's like to be afraid. Because, well, actually, Bird is going to show you what it's like to be afraid because I'm going to sneak up on him and scare him. And he'll probably be so frightened that he'll drop his book and jump up and scream. Just watch, okay?
See exotic paper clips from foreign lands in Volume 4. Ernie, what?
Nothing, Bert. Go back to your reading.
Yeah, okay. Paper clips.
That didn't work. I'll have to try a different approach.
Of course, there are so many paper clips that...
Wubba wubba, Bert!
If you have... did you say wubba wubba, Ernie?
Yes, Bert, I guess I did. Sorry.
All the paper clips.
I know what. I'll have to try a scary costume.
Wow, this is a terrific book. I'm thirsty, though. I think I'll get a glass of water.
Don't be frightened. It's only me. See? I'm wearing this real scary sheet, so I'm going to sneak up on Bert and go boo, and he's going to be so frightened that he's going to scream and drop his book. Watch this. Boo, Bert! Bert? Boo! Bert! Oh, Bert! Where's Bert? Oh, well, I guess I'll just have to frighten him some other time. Oh, what's this he was reading? Wonderful World of Paper Clips. That looks interesting. Look at that.
Ernie?
Oh, Bert! Oh, Bert, you scared me, Bert. That's not funny, Bert. Sneaking up behind me and scaring me like that?
Why are you staring at that rock?
I saw it move.
Rocks don't move.
Yeah, well, this one did. It just walked over here and stopped.
If it walked over and stopped, it's alive.
Well, that's what it is then, an alive rock.
If it's alive, it's not a rock. It's a turtle.
It's a rock, all right. It's hard like a rock. Wow, it's eating.
Rocks don't eat.
Hey, my rock is walking away. Hey, rock, come back here.
I'm sure that's no rock. It's a turtle.
Well, it's not a chicken. It's hard, and it has no feathers.
It's not a dog. It has no ears.
Yeah, well, it's not a cat either. It has no whiskers.
All I know is that rocks don't walk or eat or breathe to live.
Yeah? Well, maybe it's a kangaroo.
Kangaroos are alive.
Hey, what was that?
That was no rock.
Swing can't swing without people to swing in. A bell can't ring without people to ring it. A song can't sing without people to sing it and bring it a special kind of thing you only get from people. A slide won't slide without people to slide it. No hide and seek without people to hide it. A ride won't ride without people to ride it and provide it. A special kind of thing you only get from people. I need lots and lots of people. Where are people to play here, to stay here, and maybe spend the day here? A sandbox is a bore without people to be in it. What's a monkey bar for without people being free in it? A seesaw never saw without people seeing it. Are you agreeing it's a special kind of thing you only get from people? I need people. Where are all the people?
T. Out. 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 Out.
That's a funny walk. It's a flock of flamingos. Was a flamingo. There must be thousands of them. They eat with their heads upside down. They drink with their head upside down too. Wow, look at him fly. Flamingos.
Hey, what?
How can you sing when your teeth aren't clean?
Thank you, Brush.
You're quite welcome.
You gotta brush them every day,
or your teeth will turn to gray.
And maybe fall out from decay.
Skittle-dee-bee-bop.
Yeah. Go in my way?
Cerrado. 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 Cerrado.
La canasta está cerrada. La puerta está cerrada. Y la ventana está cerrada.
¡Abierto, abierto, abierto, abierto!
La canasta está cerrada.
Well, it's time to go back to my planet Zircon now.
Well, I hope you had a great time on Sesame Street.
Are you kidding? Why do you think I'm leaving?
Well, so long, Othmar.
Yes, so long, Oscar. It's time to blast off, to brave once more the emptiness of space, to begin again my long voyage home to the planet Zircon, sailing through the stars across the vast universe. Ah, Carl Sagan, eat your heart out. Along the great untraveled path.
Othmar, enough already. Get lost.
Yeah, I thought you'd never say it, Oscar. Okay, here I go. Start the old countdown.
10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Well, Othmar, should I call you a taxi?
Yeah, don't mind if you do, please.
Okay, you're a taxi.
Oh, that's a good one, Oscar.
Sesame Street has been brought to you today by the letters L and X, and by the number 4. Sesame Street is a production of the Children's Television Workshop.